Well, as I promised, there's going to be another great event that's going on here in Windsor and Essex County, and you can be a part of it. Of course, we were talking about the film that is due to happen here in Windsor, but an event that's already happened once before last year was Beaverfest. And this year, because backed by popular demand, it's back in our community, and both Ian France and Dave Hunter are joining us to tell us about this. Guys, this is exciting.
It is.
Again, I mean, did you ever think, Dave Hunter, that this was going to be something that was going to evolve into something that's going to happen every year?
Truthfully, yes.
Did you? Oh, I did. So you had a vision.
We did. I mean, we set our team in place a year prior. We did our due diligence. We did our homework. And we did a lot of research moving forward. And after the success of basically a first year festival, it just escalated into something that we didn't believe that would take off that quickly. And by the response of the community, it was a no-brainer for year two.
Is that part of why, Ian, you guys decided to do this too? That, I mean, obviously there's a love of music in this community, but also kind of maybe pooling the resources and getting, you know, community involvement, people down at the riverfront, having fun with their families and friends. Is that a great reason why to do this as well?
Absolutely. I mean, with the development of the new Riverfront Plaza, it was just a perfect fit for us. And with our partner, Chris Mickle, who was also involved with Pro Tenders, and he also supervised the Red Bull Air races.
Oh, yeah.
Obviously, the level of that international level of an event, we wanted to bring that flavor to a local community event down at the riverfront. And let's face it, there's been many festivals in the area that are successful. You know, God willing, ours will have the longevity of theirs. But we feel that we're stepping it up a notch in regards to the level of talent and the entertainers that we're bringing to this city.
And we are going to talk a little bit about that, but before we even get to that, last year, successfully, had over 13,000 people.
Yes.
But what was great, too, is 13,000 people, but you didn't have a venue that was completely done anyway, but you still drew in 13,000 people.
Yeah, we...
I know, that was scary then, wasn't it?
Scary and stressful. I had more hair last year.
Yeah. He did have full head of hair, but...
Yeah. I had curly hair. No, last year... I mean, it was basically what down to the last 4 days.
Yeah, the venue was sitting at about a 70% completion. What went on in the front of the house was one thing, but what was going on in the back of the house behind the stage?
That's been crazy.
It was pretty rough, but we got through it. And then plus the weather, if you can recall, I think we had like 28 days of rain in the last 40, and it was just sleepless nights.
41 out of 60 days of rain.
So 41 out of 60. I don't know how you guys managed to get through it, but you persevered because, like you said, you knew this was going to be something successful for this community.
Well, I mean, moving forward, you want to make sure that you have that positive
Absolutely.
Outlook. I mean, going in with a negative kind of perspective on things, obviously, is not going to do any good. And between the three of us and putting our heads together, everything just meshed perfectly. It was a perfect bond for. Who did what and who was organizing this or who took care of this. And everybody had their own niche and their own specialty. We've had our disagreements, but most, business partners tend to do.
Yeah, absolutely.
That's true. I mean, it's going to happen. But in the end, what you guys are working for is putting on a successful event, and you did.
Absolutely.
It was great last year. And I actually have to be honest. I went, and I'll tell you, I wondered, they can't top this. How are they going to top it? But this year you have.
We have, absolutely.
You just announced this just a couple of days ago, what you guys are going to be having here. So let's talk about, for those who don't know, what we're expecting to see. And this is Friday, Saturday, Sunday.
Yep.
Let's talk about Friday. What are we expecting to
see? On Friday, what you're looking at is the Trues are going to be the only returning band from last year that we're bringing back. And we're having them headline for 3 Days Grace, who easily one of the top Canadian acts going.
Probably the top Canadian act.
So if you look
that's
at
a coup.
So if you look at that, demographic, we're looking at bringing in, that'll be a little bit of a younger demographic. The Saturday, we're breaking out in a little bit of an older demographic, going for an older clientele, and Honeymoon Suite, Puddle of Mud will be opening up for the Cult.
Nice. I, of course, not old enough to remember a Honeymoon Suite.
No, neither are we.
None of us,
not
right?
Well, my dad said he loved them.
I do, actually. No.
My parents have said that they were pretty cool, pretty groovy.
Sadly, I do remember them.
They're good.
Terrific band. Great Canadian following. All the original band members from Honeymoon Suite, as well as all the original band members from the Cult, are returning for this. So we have two rock and roll genres at Sunday. Sunday will be our country genre, and we have Doc Walker.
This is different, though, because you didn't do this last year.
Correct.
So you've decided, let's try something a little bit different, add the country element to it. So, sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt
you. No, that's okay.
Who are we bringing in for country, then?
Doc Walker and Emerson Drive.
Love
both
them.
Very solid Canadian acts that have a good following in this area.
Is this an all-ages event?
Yes.
Okay, it's an all-ages event.
And that was one of the stepping stones that we learned from mistakes from last year.
Okay.
Like we had a basically it was a pop day where it was all ages, but because it's such a huge community event that we felt that we should open it to the entire community.
Smart.
Yeah, we had a lot of feedback. People wanted to come down with their teens and their family members, and they weren't able to do it because it was a 19 plus for the rock and roll day. So we've opened it up for everybody to be able to come down and enjoy.
But I mean, I'm sure it is because this is relatively new to you guys doing this. This is also trial and error to kind of determine what ends up working with our community.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
And clearly, I mean, they obviously loved it enough to come forward to say, hey guys, you know what, we'd like to see this, can we do this?
Yeah.
So that's a good thing there.
And we fished a little bit on the internet by putting little teasers out of trailers of you know, some of the bands that we were potentially looking at the time. And you know, some of the response of the walls on Facebook were fantastic.
Yeah.
I really hope the 3 Days Grace shows up.
Yeah.
Surprise.
Paying attention to it. See, do you see yourselves getting, I mean, I know you want to continue to do this. Do you see it getting bigger and bigger and the bands being bigger and bigger? Maybe even the venue changing too? Or, you know, is that something that's a possibility or always keeping it local?
We're trying not to get too far ahead of ourselves, but we have a 5 and a 10 year plan with this company. We plan to be here for a long time. There's no reason that Windsor can't support and make this one of the most premier festivals in southwestern Ontario, much like Sarnia has, or Brantford, even Ottawa. You know, we feel that Windsor has a great, as far as the venue, yeah, there could be a time, but the venue itself, we like the intimacy of it. Yes, it holds 10 to 12,000 people, but it's a unique situation where we're not just dropping everybody into a farm field and, you know, hoping. It's a viable venue that...
That great we can for more than downtown.
It's absolutely fantastic.
The skyline and the backdrop is just amazing.
And the economic impact that we had from last year from restaurants and different places downtown actually called us after the, I think it was a Saturday show, and basically said we ran out of food. We had so many people come in, and the overflow.
Now that's a problem a restaurant will want to have.
Exactly.
You know? So that's good. So I mean, it's a domino effect of what you guys are doing. One, it's community involvement. Two, it's getting you and your family, your kids down to the riverfront, enjoying an event together. And then on top of it, economically, great for the businesses downtown to see you guys there.
Yep.
And opening up the diversity, I mean, great idea that you guys added that element of the country, the older group.
Right.
So this is kind of like it opened to anybody, really.
And that was our plan because it's hard to get people. Let's face it, it's tough times right now.
Absolutely.
I mean, there's announcements of companies closing and layoffs, et cetera. It's hard to get people to come out.
Yeah.
2-3 nights in a row.
Yeah.
So you need to be able to offer that diversity in your festival so that, you know, we can be successful.
True.
And because the last thing we want to see is to bring down an event at the riverfront and there's no bodies coming through the gate.
Yeah.
That's the last thing anybody wants to see.
Well,
so
I have a feeling based on last year, you guys will probably do the exact same thing, if not more maybe because of, you know, the area's all finished. And why are you shaking your head, Dave?
Right. I think without a doubt we're going to double it.
Oh, okay. I thought you were saying, no, we're not going to do well. I'm thinking, wait a minute.
No.
If I want to pick up tickets, is there a website I can go to? Is there a phone
Absolutely.
Number I can call?
Beaverfest.ca.
Okay.
Or you can pick up tickets at Dr. Disc and Jam Space as well in Windsor.
And tickets are running you approximately how much, or is it contingent upon each?
No, everything's the same. $40 general admission and $75 roughly for VIP.
Nice.
And then there's weekend rock passes that are available, but that's all available on the internet. They can look at the website for that.
Nice, I like it. And before we go, I know there's a hint of something because I, you know, people tell me stuff. My people talk to your people, and some of those people talk to other people.
Uh-oh.
I hear that there might be something else that you might be adding. I know it's not official, but are you able to talk a little bit about what the potential might be because you're in the works with it?
It is.
I'm not talking about your relationship with Fergie. I'm
there
talking
you go.
About.
Oh, wow.
Fergie. Oh, I let it out.
She doesn't write or she doesn't call.
We are still hopefully looking at expanding it to a fourth day. We're still in negotiations with certain things. And on that, we'll probably bring back the pop genre on the Thursday evening.
Nice.
Yeah, so that it just depends on scheduling. And because the last thing we want to do also is bring talent that just isn't the level that we want.
Yeah.
Okay, we're not, we have a certain level.
So is that why you didn't ask me to sing? You're quiet.
No, that's not. We crickets in the room now.
All of a sudden, yeah, you seriously couldn't hear crickets. It's like, all right, I knew it wasn't that good.
You want to come sing? No problem.
No.
National anthem.
Not even the national anthem. Not a good thing.
Okay.
Not even. You know how people say, at least I sing good in the shower?
No.
Not even in the shower. It's not
okay.
a good thing.
I'll ask your boys.
Yeah, that's why they usually typically leave. Mom's going to go take a shower. We're out of here.
Yeah. Keys to the car, please.
So this is a great event. Again, you don't want to miss this. Tickets are still available. Let's talk about the date before we go.
June 1st, 2nd, and 3rd. It's a Friday, Saturday, Sunday, with the potential of possibly the Thursday, which would be the 31st of May.
And that'll come out once you guys, if they check out your website too.
Yeah.
You have a Facebook group too.
We do.
So any of that information, they can find it for you. If it's all online. Get a hold of you, how
absolutely.
Do you guys do that?
That's exactly it.
It's all online.
Well, thank you very much, guys. I'm excited
for having us.
Before we go, put you on the spot. Favorite band that's coming in?
Favorite band that's coming in?
Yep.
The Cult.
The Cult.
100%.
Nice. Yours.
You know what? I'm going to go Honeymoon Suite.
Really?
Yeah, I really am.
Dave Hunter.
You know, I might be dating myself, but if you spend some time in YouTube, their music, it's just hit after hit after hit.
I'm trying to remember what's off the top of my head right now.
It just brings me back to my childhood, like 10 years old, 11, 12 years old.
Yep. Okay.
Way Babies and New Girl Now.
New Girl Now. Oh,
Burning in Love.
Burning in Love. I do remember that. I think New Girl Now was one of my favorites.
Yep. Would you sing us the chorus?
No, I'm not doing that.
Not a chance.
Or to you guys. And the staff here and anybody in Windsor and Essex County. All right, thank you so much, guys. And again, check out their website for more information. It's a great event that you don't want to miss here in June, and you want to pick up those tickets, so make sure to do that. Have a great day, everyone. And do you want to sing us out?
Go ahead, Ian.
Not a chance.
I got a new girl. Come on.
Take your soapbox and
thank you very much.
Do it. I dare you.
We're all good.
I got a new girl now. Come on. And she's old.